The Shimmerverb by Eventide is their latest addition to the H9 plugin series. The plugin uses pitch shifting, reverb and feedback to add a glossy, heavenly reverb to your tracks. We'll go over the sound and how it works so you know if this plugin can be useful for you. I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. So, the Eventide Shimmerverb is a reverb which uses pitch shifting and feedback to add a glossy, heavenly sound to your vocal, guitar, samples and synth. I'll demonstrate by using this synth. Here's the Shimmerverb. It uses the common layout used by all H9 series plugins. Here are the input and output volume sliders and the dry-wet control. The reverb decay changes how quickly the reverb dies out, and if you shorten it, it will also reduce the attack of the reverb. The reverb size is obvious. It sets how big or how small the reverb will sound. The delay knob here is placed after the reverb and before the pitch shift in the signal chain, and so determines the delay time of the pitch shifter. You can set the delay in milliseconds or in note values, either in sync to the project tempo, or you have to set a tempo manually. No tempo tap function in this plugin, although other plugins in the H9 series do have one. There are two pitch shifters, which are placed parallel, so next to each other. The range of both is from -2 octaves to +2 octaves, but it only focuses on the areas of the 4th, 5th, 1 octave plus a 5th and 2 octaves, so it always sounds musically and harmonically pleasing with this plugin. You cannot get a dissonant pitch shift out of this one. And by using two pitch shifters, you can go from chorusy to big differences in shift. The three dials over here are simple EQ knobs, which are placed after the reverb and pitch shift and help you to tweak the sound and determine the way the feedback will sound. The feedback dial does exactly what it says. It feeds the pitch reverb back into the reverb and creates a feedback loop. If you turn it up, it will get into pitch kill mode, which removes the pitch shifters from the feedback loop, and turning it even further will enable freeze mode, which freezes the sound. Now, instead of dialing the feedback all the way up to enable freeze, you can also use the freeze button down below, which does exactly the same. The hot switch next to it is a sort of an instant preset knob. You set it by holding the knob down for a while. It starts to blink, and then you can set the settings you want. And then when you press the hot switch, it immediately uses the settings you set. This can be useful if you want to do one-off effects once in a while, and it saves you a lot of automation. Now, other than the hot switch, you have these two knobs for the ribbon controller, which do exactly the same. You press one of the buttons and make a setting, and you do the same with the other one. And the ribbon allows you to smoothly morph between these two settings. So you have three instant preset recalls, a ribbon controller and a freeze button. The creative use of these knobs is very handy, especially if you want to create movement with this Shimmerverb. I used to do this effect by pitch shifting myself and add a reverb, but this plugin does it all at one time with a lot more control and a sweet feedback loop. The Shimmerverb fits nicely between the other H9 plugins like the Undulator, check my review here, and has the same quality and feel. It adds a shimmery sound for sure. You can add angelic-like reverb easily, which you can use to open up a mix if it's already full. And you can even use it for soundscape-like effects. Pretty neat, and most important, it's useful. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so you won't miss out on any new video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!